know. Maybe.
Whose hand is that? Is that mine? Do we know? Anyone?
In the off-topic class.
Like a hand puts down the glass.
Whose hand is that?
And Andy was like, who is that? I don't remember.
Did we credit them properly?
I feel like I did that.
We need to know who's that in the intro.
You guys probably just went around
like,
me.
It was like 3 years ago. I don't think anybody knows.
Well, you definitely you weren't alive.
We gotta figure out who it is, because we don't want to give them any free advertising.
Could have been yours. Yeah. Hey, welcome to Off Topic episode 155. Sometimes they tell me the episode, sometimes they don't. This time they did. Hi, I'm Michael. Joining us, we have Lindsay.
Hello.
Special guest, Slow Beef.
Hi.
Jeremy's
here. Hi.
You're really far away.
I know,
Is it my fault? Am I grabbing
you? No, it's Lindsay's fault. If Lindsay would bump him to here and you've bumped him to there.
No, whenever Lindsay's on, she sits there.
No, I said Lindsay has bumped you to there, and then you've gone further down. And then Andy's here for some reason.
Yeah.
He wormed his way.
Yeah. It's Jurassic World.
Gotta set up that trilogy.
Did you see it, Slow Beef?
No.
Okay.
No, I'm just following along. Pretending.
Glazed look.
No, if it's not Boss Baby, I haven't seen it.
Wait till they introduce raptors.
Oh,
well, that's season 2 of Boss Baby. It's really good, but anyway.
There's shows where, like, it's I can understand, like, Boss Baby, and we have this with, like, Ladybug and even with Cupcake, where, like, I'm like, you're in. You're wallowing in Boss Baby already. Do you ever get to the point where you're like, it's not good, but like, I just hope they make a season 3 so something's different?
No.
No?
No. It's not good. Season 2 did it for me. When it's the babies versus the senior citizens, and I'm like, yeah.
Everybody's pooping their pants.
You're right. And people are just shitting. And
diapers everywhere.
People can barely talk.
Yeah.
They're making a new movie, so I know that's in my future, you know? It's
just, Boss Baby 2?
Yeah, they're making Boss Baby 2. The Boss Baby 2.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Nice.
Holy shit.
Yeah, season 2 of Miraculous Ladybug came on Netflix. And
half of it. Half of it.
Yes, but it was still kind of sad.
It's coming out waves.
Michael and I were like, yes, thank God.
They did a split.
Okay. New episodes.
I might be opening up a whole can of worms here,
okay.
But it's a Boss Baby question.
Okay. Right.
Is it somebody else's soul trapped in a baby, or is it just a super smart baby like Stewie from Family Guy?
It's actually a kid who's just imagining all of it. They just cover all the plot holes like that, where it's a kid making up the whole story.
What?
Are you serious?
No, totally serious.
That's the whole twist.
He's telling his daughter how he had trouble with his brother being a baby and getting attention. And then at the end, like, Dad, is that really what happened? Well, it's how I remember it. And there's all, like, animated stuff where he pretends he's a ninja and they, like, hand-draw.
That seems like a cop-out.
Yeah. It is total cop-out.
It was all a dream plot.
Yeah. So there's one point halfway through the movie, they're having a big action sequence, right? It's like there's explosions and shit. And then they flash to the mother looking outside and they show, no, they're just two kids playing. But the baby's still wearing a suit. And this bothers me so much because I'm like, wait, but they're showing it's not real. But he's wearing the suit. So is he really wearing the suit? Or did they fuck up?
It's like an existential crisis.
That's a great question. That's what I'm talking about. You start going, well, that's
That's
great. Notice in this baby?
Yeah.
How did this slip through?
That's the thing about, like, raptors for terrorists, I'll forget that. But the suit baby, that'll bother me the rest of my life. I'll have to, like, hunt down who wrote that, and they'll have forgotten.
You know, ask about the suit, they're like, what the fuck's wrong with you?
Like,
care about this?
46 minutes, 37 seconds in, sir, you show outside the fantasy. The baby is clearly wearing a suit.
Oh, my God. Dipping stuff for a blooming onion?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my God. Also a blooming onion.
Blooming onions are great.
Dude, I saw that. It's like, hey, you want a big fucking onion? Shove this in your mouth. I'm like, yeah. I guess
it's
I do.
It's so tasty, though. It's so fucking
good. It's really good.
Speaking of which, and going back to your butter
conversation,
that's like a
horseradish sauce.
You want to get food like that and also be a huge fatty, go to the Texas State Fair. They have deep fried butter, like sticks of butter that you
toss in the deep fryer. Yeah, I've seen deep fried butter. Yeah, yeah.
And you eat it. And it's great.
And then you eat it, butter and it's great.
My jaw dropped, and I can't tell if it's because I'm disgusted or I really want to try it.
Yeah, deep fried butter is the thing.
They have deep fried like Twinkies.
Kool-Aid. They have deep fried kinds of
Oreos.
They have that down at the Jersey Shore, like deep fried like Oreos and Twinkies and all that. And there's this place now, they have like chocolate covered everything. They have like chocolate covered Twinkies, chocolate covered
stick of butter.
I mean, that looks good.
It looks like a melted corn dog.
Well, because the butter melts, so it's just a fried gel and melted
It's fried butter in butter.
Yeah,
wow. The picture is
fucking disgusting.
I would have to try it. I would have to.
You hear the popping of like the arteries like filling up.
Oh,
it's just like as they like shut down.
Yeah, I feel like that's one of those. Like I'd encounter it once in my life, and I'd say no, and then I'd never encounter it again, and I'd always wonder. you know,
what life would have been if you had that.
It's like, exactly. I had my first Twinkie a few years ago at their apartment, and I haven't had one since.
Well,
I was one and done. I was like,
that's the correct
good.
Response to a Twinkie. Yeah, Twinkies are okay.
I mean, that was pretty good.
Twinkies are
they were great
overrated.
In my childhood. Now that I'm an adult and I've had one again, I'm like, I
now that I've had things that aren't like Twinkies.
I mean, what do you? What's the fucking chocolate shit you still stuff your face with?
Ding dongs are another story. All right.
Oh, ding dongs are not as good as Twinkies.
This is nutter fuckers. They're all great.
This is fucking funny.
The nutter butters. Yeah.
Ding dongs are on. What is it? Ding dongs, ring dings, ding dongs, dinglings. They're on Prime now. The thing with Prime now is it always changes. Sometimes you get shit and then you go to order the next day.
That's
why
they don't have
Slim Jim,
really.
Oh shit.
They just have the little.
They have knockoff gyms.
Yeah.
But like.
Not gyms.
Lindsay is great.
Slim Jim.
Slender Jim. Slender James. Like a classy Slim Jim.
Lindsay's great for like ordering Prime now shit and then just like leaving it there. Like she'll especially order shit late at night. And they'll drop it off at like 10 o'clock, and I gotta like harass her, like, you gotta fucking take it in. Like, one, if there's like perishables, you gotta put them in the fridge.
Yeah.
And two, it's like, people just take our shit. It's just like sitting, like, ooh, there's a bag of, it's 2 a.m., just a bag of Amazon sitting there. I'll take it.
Yeah.
So it's like, she'll like half ass, like, go down, answer the door, take it, and then just like throw it in the hallway and then close the door and come back upstairs.
It's
in the house, it's good enough.
You and like, Pat are the same human beings.
But
so
it's the best part. I don't know what I did. I did something. Like, I don't think it was the morning because she's not that much of an animal, but it was just the other day where like she ordered a bunch of shit from Prime Now. And I was leaving the house. Maybe I was being like a fat fucking getting like fast food run at night or something. I don't remember what it was.
Classic,
but I remember,
Michael.
Classic me. I remember leaving and there was like 4 Prime Now bags at the door. And I left. I came back and like one of the bag was like knocked over. And I was like, the fuck? And
like
I picked up the bag. And a box of fucking ding dongs was ripped open and like 2 were missing. And then that was it though. So like she came downstairs and like,
where's my ding dong?
Got him and then went back upstairs. And I was like,
my God, I need it.
She came down and was like, give mama what she wants. And then she went back upstairs. And I was like, you came down for the ding dongs and then left everything else. And she's like, where I wanted them.
That's awesome.
God damn. That's incredible. Like, I want to say it was the gym, but to give her credit, I don't think it was like 8 o'clock in the morning, but it was like night. I left in the span of like 15 minutes. I was like, is that a raccoon get in here? Like, what happened here? It was just like one bag was in disarray and just like, I'm about to dig dogs.
You're good to go. Thank you. Going back to the state fair, you can get, I think they put marshmallows on a stick, like 3 of them. They roll it in chocolate, and then they roll it in live ants. They're like, here you go, buddy.
Oh, live ants?
Yeah.
Thanks, wow. Sarah.
Those poor ants.
This is a Slack from Sarah. I just find it funny. Hey, when you're done with a podcast, can you come by the post room after you're done with the podcast?
Yeah.
When you're done with it,
you mean after the podcast?
Yeah, when you're done with it.
She's like, her brain turned off while she was typing that.
The worst thing is she probably had Steffi read the Slack before she even sent it.
And Steffi went, yeah, it's great.
Everybody in the support room, we've read almost every single email Sarah's ever sent out because we all proofread it. Because she was like, does this look okay? Does this look okay? It's like, I don't even think I was supposed to read this.
Double checking that stuff.
Yeah.
This is confidential, actually.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. This is about me.
I ordered a bunch of shit, and they had a pound of fresh mozzarella cheese, but it was like, usually fresh mozzarella is like in a ball.
Yeah.
And you gotta do all the work.
It's kind of wet.
Right. It's
some
it's
guy
wet.
Named Vito is like,
yeah,
folded
yeah, yeah.
It.
So
yeah.
I'm done. And
yeah.
And you know, he puts it in. But this was like, quiet you. It was almost like,
go on.
It was almost like a meat, like a piece of salami where it's like oblong and it was pre-sliced.
Ooh.
So I thought like, well, that's great. I'll order that. I can just have like a slice at a time. So I got 2 pounds of it.
Yeah.
And when I got it, I got 2 of them. I got it and I was like, I'll open it up. I'll just have a slice. I ate the whole pound. I ate a pound of cheese. At like 11 o'clock at night. I was just like playing video games and I was like, where'd my cheese go?
There's some air in there too.
Then the next day or 2 days later, I opened the next one, ate half a pound, and then I had to stop. And that's still like intact. Like I haven't gone back to that other half a pound, but I did order more food the other day. I'm like, I gotta get another pound of cheese.
Yeah.
So now I got another pound waiting in the wing. It's so good. It's such good cheese.
It's not just bad.
Was it worth the shit,
cheese?
Though? Was that
exactly.
worth it?
No, well,
he's
like,
lactose intolerant.
Yeah, but like, I'm usually at home. I'm awful out of the house because I don't take my pills with me. At home, I've got a couple of boxes of like lactate pills.
Yeah.
And they save me 70% of the time.
Yeah, cat.
Sometimes they just don't work. Yeah. But most of the time, if I take them and then immediately eat the cheese, I'm good. What kills me the most is because I'm really bad about taking them with me, is going to Alamo. Because I usually.
Cat's awful about that too.
When I go to Alamo Draft House, I'm literally there. I order queso and I go, I forgot my lactate pills. And it's just like, usually the ride home, I'm like, it's coming. Oh, of course I still get it.
Yeah, Kat does that. Like,
I get a baked pretzel, which comes with mustard and queso. I get chips and queso. And then I'm like, well, give me the blue cheeseburger or the mac and cheese or anything with cheese. I don't care.
When we go to Hop Dotty, Kat will forget it. And then she'll get a shake. She'll be like, I really want a milkshake.
I'm like, you can get it.
Just, you know, we'll get home quick.
It's like 1,000 knives in your stomach is what it is. Yeah. Like people are stabbing you from the
inside. I can
see
the misery on her face when it sets in.
It's awful.
That's like, I love it.
Every I'm like, that's what you get. Yeah, I have no sympathy.
No, yeah. I'm like, you knew the risks coming here.
I don't feel bad. You ate cheese. What do you want from me?
When we get down to like the last four teams, I lose it. I can't do it. I just start shaking. It's too much pressure.
He was in the fucking army.
Listen, but we're talking about real pressure. We're talking about Call of Duty Blackout.
Did you guys see that? The second he went, listen, something flung from his fingers into my eye.
I'm sure it was healthy, whatever it was. Something good to have
in your
eye.
Organic. It was probably your Coke spill. I just poured your own goddamn
Do you have any more of that unbranded soda?
It's a tiny bit, yes. Okay. I pulled it up and I went like this and I saw Slippy going like,
yeah.
Is that what I think it is?
I was trying to figure out a segue. I'm like, Spyro, maybe. You know?
Sometimes when you're playing Spyro, even though you love it so much, you're just soft.
Yeah. You know what the hell's going on down here?
What's going on? I love this game.
Never played Spyro soft in my life.
Yeah, but some people have, and they don't need to feel ashamed.
It's true.
If you want to get the fire back in your dragon, check out Slowbeef. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for
me.
Sitting in front of this the whole time.
No, that was I brought this when you were doing the ad, I moved it because this one stick was kind of in front of your face
because they punched in.
Oh, nice.
So I scooched it out of the way a little.
Oh, you're the best.
I was super subtle about it. Nobody saw it. No. Check out the post show. I'm gonna tear ass. You'll have to watch it to find out. Like sticking his asshole out. Nintendo's been doing that the last like 5 years. Like Yoshi wants in the ass.
Because he shits out eggs.
That's nothing to do with it though. Look at him. He's like, Yoshi, like fuck my ass.
It must be so frustrating for Nintendo to want that and then the internet took over Bowser. For that.
Yeah, Bowsette.
That was a whole thing. Bowsette is that died down, I think.
I mean, it died down because it's canon. Yoshette is definitely a thing.
Yoshette was there.
I didn't see Yoshette. I saw Boozette, and I saw Chain Chomp.
Chomp was cool looking. Chomp was badass.